crash is something which affects anyone with something to lose. Everyone who has passion about something is our best friend and our worst enemy. The way we view pressure in this program is similar to sweat. The harder you physically work at something in the gyms, on the track, or pitches, in the courts, then the more you sweat. The after effects of hard physical effort, the aching limbs, the fatigue accompanying the sweat. When we've completed training, what do? We walk around drenched in sweat and go straight to the next session, or do we wash the sweat away, rest, reset those aching limbs, and recharge ready to go again? This program will teach the athlete to do the same with pressure. The pressure is the sweat. The more they want something, the more important something or someone, an achievement or goal is to them, the higher the pressure. The more importance they place on a target or overall event, the more the pressure, more pressure they'll place upon themselves. The more pressure they create and invite upon themselves. So, similar to sweat, once we've worked hard to gain something, we wash that sweat away. The same thing we do with pressure. We use the passion, we use the enthusiasm, the determination, and we wash away all of the negative impacts. So, this process follows five key stages. Stage one, recognition. Many coaches, supervisors, managers will use exposure type training to put their athletes, patients, or staff in positions of mild threat to help desensitize them. And by recognizing the implications of pressure, we'll not only familiarize ourselves with its effects, but we begin to recognize them. And when we do start to recognize what pressure feels like, we know when it's hit us, so we know when it's time to do something. Stage two, we then rationalize the pressure. Desensitizing it in the present. We accept that we're bringing it upon ourselves because we're passionate about something, because we yearn for greatness. And this pressure is simply a byproduct of our hard work, a byproduct of our desire. And therefore, as we can create it, then so too can we control and remove the negatives. Stage three, having exposed and desensitized the pressure, we remove it by grounding ourselves in the moment and taking our mind to a place of pure control, stabilizing ourselves mentally and resetting ourselves physically. Stage four, reassuring. Next up, we reassure ourselves and we start bringing the attention onto our strengths. We focus on the physiological, psychological, behavioral, emotional qualities which we have full control over, the things which the pressure has enabled us to develop. Stage five, finally, we reinforce this. We reinforce our self-belief by vividly seeing how we're going to use these things, these areas that this pressure has helped us develop to succeed at the task at hand in the competitive scenario.